This is how you set up a targeted ability with Spam, framework for spells, projectiles, abilities, and magic. With Spam, you design your abilities directly in the editor, and then you cast them by simply telling the framework when and where. Start by adding an ability invoker to the character that will be casting abilities. I'll select my player and add the ability invoker component to it. Open the ability and effects window under Tools, Abilities and Effects. Click Create New Ability, give the ability a name, and click Create under Targeted Ability. Here you set up the ability's properties. I'll give it a cooldown of 1 second, check Require Ability Target, and leave the rest unchanged. You can find more information about all properties and settings in the documentation linked in the description. Scroll down to the Effects and Times section. This is where you set up what you want the ability to do when it's activated. I want this ability to do damage, so I'll add a damage effect to it. Scroll down to VFX, click Create New VFX, and add your visual effect to the on-hit VFX slot. I'll check Spawn a Target Base, and my VFX needs an offset of 0.2 in the Y-axis to display properly. Select your caster in the hierarchy, and create a child game object to hold your ability. Select it, and click As Targeted Ability. This will automatically set up the dependencies of the ability component. For this demo, I'll add a pre-supplied component cast ability at mouse position, so I can cast ability when I click the mouse. The last step is to add some targets. This is done by adding the component ability target to the objects that should be affected by abilities. I've already added this component to the target prefab. I've also added a very simple script that turns the target into ragdolls when they take damage. This script is an example of how you implement your game's logic by simply implementing one of the interfaces exposed by the framework. That's it, the ability is now ready to be spammed. But I think this ability would be much better as an area of effect ability, where each strike happens with a slight delay after the previous, so I'll go ahead and set that up now. Select the ability in the abilities window again, and remove the VFX for it. The visual effects will be handled with ability effects now instead. Go to the effects and time sections, click create new effect, and then create a spawn particles ability effect. Assign the particles that should spawn, check spawn a target base, and give it a lifetime that's longer than your visual effect. I need to offset my spawn point by 0.2 here as well in the y-axis. Spawn particle effects are automatically pooled, and I'll set my pool size to 5 since my ability will affect up to 5 targets. Go back to the abilities tab and select your ability. Click add effect and assign your particle effect. My VFX has a small delay before it strikes the target, so I'll reorder my ability effects to make the lightning strike first, and then add a small delay before the damage is dealt by increasing the time it takes for the lightning to be applied. Check area of effect, give it some radius and a max targets value. For this ability I want my ability effects to be applied all at once per target, so I'll set effect application to per target. I also want the effects to be slightly delayed between each target and not all at once, so I'll add an effect application delay of 0.1 seconds. That's it, the ability is now ready to be spammed. Spam has more features not shown in this video, like projectile abilities, raycast abilities, and syncing with animations and sound effects. If you already purchased Spam, first of all, thank you, and I'd be very grateful if you wrote a review on the asset store. You're welcome to join the Spam Discord server for any questions you might have. Link is in the description down below.